You are listening to the Starter Girls podcast with Jennifer Loading. Whether you are starting a project, starting a business, starting a brand, or starting a movement, we are here to talk about it. And I am super thrilled to have Mica Alexander on the show today here in person. Yay! So, Mica, real quick, I'm going to tell our audience a little bit about you, and then we're going to jump right into this. I'm super excited to chat with you today. So, all right. So, Mica is an adventurer by heart. Having traveled the world as a career military spouse with three kids in tow, she's used to figuring things out on her own. Connecting, sharing stories, and serving others are Mika's passions. She holds two master's degrees and worked as an executive in acute psychiatric care for 15 years prior to her current endeavor. Through her love of people, quest for adventure, and travel expertise, she founded her company, Tokyo Escapes. I love the name of that, by the way. I just like it. Mica builds bucket list travel adventures to Japan and serves as the group's guide, helping others find the adventure in themselves. Yay. I love it. So welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm really excited.
Yeah, super excited to have you here. So I want to jump right into this really quick because I want to talk about this. You've told us a little bit about how all this came about, but I want to talk about this Tokyo Escapes. I want you to tell us a little bit how this sort of obviously derived from a passion that you have, but obviously you lived over there. So I want you to tell us a little bit about how this evolved and what this company offers and what makes you unique.
Okay, awesome. Thank you. So yes, we're Tokyo Escapes. So my husband just retired Air Force. So he was career military. So we've been fortunate to live in Asia as well as in Europe. And so we lived in Japan almost 5 years. And when we got back to the States in 2018, people kept asking us, you know, people would always say, where are you from? That's like the big thing, you know, where are you from? And then our kids would always say, Mom, where do we say we're from? Right. You know, like, we're not really from, we're from all over. So I'm like, you know, people kept asking us about Japan. And I got my MBA about almost 6 or 7 years ago. And so I was like, well, I have an MBA. And my husband was like, yeah, maybe we should think about taking people to Japan. So that's how we started. And so what's great about us is that we're not really a travel agent per se, but we set up everything and then we go with them. Because we lived outside Tokyo, we're about 45 minutes outside Tokyo. So we know Tokyo really well. And so ours is different because we're not going to like set it up and send you off and say, good luck,
right.
You know, we actually go with them and we are set to take people to the Olympics, although it's been rescheduled. I still have my Olympic tickets, so we are set to do that next year.
I love it. Yes. I love it. So I've never been to Tokyo, never been in that area. What is it like there? Tell us a little bit about that. What's it like?
It's the Japanese are the kindest people you would ever meet. I mean, they really enjoy Americans. It's interesting because in Tokyo, you'll go into shops sometimes and, you know, everyone's speaking Japanese, but they'll have American music playing. A lot of Michael Jackson, a lot of 80s, 90s. Wow.
Yeah.
So they enjoy our culture and our movies. I actually had a friend of mine, her uncle said to me, Mika-san, and I do speak some Japanese, which helps, but he's like, Mika-san, do you know Robert De Niro? I'm like, yeah, no, America's really big.
That's so funny.
I mean, because it's such a small country compared to us.
Yeah.
And their population, it's densely populated, but it's different and the culture is different because even the celebrities there, they go out, you know, with the mainstream and people don't bother them. There's not like paparazzi and things like that. It's very respectful.
Okay.
Yes.
Interesting.
Yes.
Interesting. It's so funny though. You know how when you, I guess maybe the, I don't want to say like preconceived ideas, maybe that's the word I'm looking for, how we think of other countries. And when you were talking about that, you know, they're asking you, do you know an actor? You're like, no, he's not my cousin.
Right.
It's so funny. It's so funny. This is a big country, you know, and you know, we talk about, I always joke about the 6 degrees of separation, how I think in Dallas, we only have like, you know, that 2 degrees of separation, but there's still a lot of people. And, you know, it's hard to know everybody here.
It is. Well, and it's wide open spaces.
Exactly.
I mean, compared to Japan, in Tokyo is 48 million people.
Okay.
With all the prefectures surrounding it. So it's pretty densely populated. And then there's other areas of Japan that aren't as populated. It's more like the country, like the plains here in America.
Yeah.
So Yeah, just explaining that to people. I'll tell you one thing that I really had to get used to when we moved back was driving.
Driving.
Because we lived in England and then we lived in Japan, so I didn't really drive.
Okay.
Because we took the trains and we walked everywhere. So
interesting.
It's been and then my daughter got her driver's license and had teaching her how to drive. And it's just, she's like, Mom, everybody drives so fast here.
They do.
Yes,
they do. We're going through that driving right now with my youngest. So I know it's like that, that's like a whole nother trauma level there, being in the car with your teenager driving. So I can only imagine if you're not used to that.
And then just driving on the right side of the road. Because I drove on the left side of the road for almost 7 years.
Right.
So coming back and then driving on the right, I'm on the right. And even now, we've been back almost 2 years. And still, once in a while, I'll turn and I'm like, I'm going the wrong way.
That's so funny.
I need to turn around.
Get conditioned. You've been there for a while. That's awesome. I love it. So let me ask you kind of a fun question. I always like to ask this because I kind of feel like as entrepreneurs, you know, some people are just, I don't know, it's like they come out of the womb and they're born entrepreneurs. They just know they're going to be like, create something at some point. And other people, it sort of kind of develops for them. Something happens and then they have this inspired action that gets them there. Did you ever think when you were young you would be doing something like this?
Never. Never in a million years.
Isn't that funny?
No way. And my husband always says his family worked in the military and worked in government.
Okay.
And my family as well, they worked a lot of, you know, working for other people. But I did have a few people in my family that were entrepreneurs.
Okay.
And I just, you know, I saw what they went through and they had to work really hard to become successful.
Right.
A lot of long hours. I'm excited we're doing this. It offers things that, you know, although you work kind of all the time, right? Mm-hmm. You have a lot of flexibility and you decide. It's not like working for somebody else. So it's the benefits definitely outweigh. Yeah. Anything else.
I would agree with you on that 100%. But also, too, I think and I've talked about this over and over, you know, you've heard the saying, when you love what you do, you never work a day in your life. And so I think when you really love what you're able to do, you almost think of that work as kind of your hobby. And it doesn't really feel like work. When you don't enjoy what you're doing, that feels like work.
Right.
You know?
Right.
So I could certainly see, and that's what I think is so great about entrepreneurship. If you are that, you know, that enterprising mind, have that enterprising mindset, you get to be creative and take those passions that you love and put that into something that is good for other people and it can help other people.
Yes.
And so I think that's where the blessing comes in.
Well, and I think with us, you know, a lot of people are hesitant to travel overseas. Especially given with the crisis right now. But when we get back to traveling, you know, people are hesitant to go to non-English speaking countries. I think we offer something really unique because we're Americans that lived in the Japanese culture.
Right.
So we can bridge both.
Right.
And we're not going to let, you know, we're not going to let you walk into the wrong bathroom or,
yeah.
or say the wrong thing or, you know.
I love that, Mica. That's awesome. So as a child, was there anything, I guess, like, was there any child impact or something in your childhood that impacted who you are today? Anything that stands out in your mind that just really defines?
So I thought about this a lot.
It's a tough question sometimes. I know.
Because there's a lot. I mean, you grow from your experiences. There's a lot of things.
Right.
I would say, so I'm Mexican-American. My father is Mexican and my mom is Caucasian.
Okay.
And my mom was a professor when I was growing up. And we lived primarily in the Midwest. And my name was Mica, you know, and I look different. My name was different. So being biracial was definitely, it definitely impacted me because I usually was the only, like, Mexican-American in the class.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah. I think being a, you know, mixed culture, biracial, you know, there's a lot of people in America now. I mean, we're a melting pot.
Right.
So I think embracing it, I had to as a young child. As a young child, I didn't like it. You know, I was always the different one. I was always had the different name and I looked different and I sounded different and my family looked different. So I think I really had to grow into embracing that. And then our kids are mixed. And so helping them embrace that,
sure.
you know, as a teenager and becoming young adults, Because people are always going to try to define you.
Absolutely.
You know, how you look, how you talk, whatever, but it's up to you to decide.
Right.
Yeah.
100%. And I think they do that all across because I talk about these labels that everybody places on people, you know, and I just got through taking this social psychology course. I finally wrapped that up. Yes. And we were talking about, you know, things in there about stereotyping and homogeneity, bias out group type stuff where you put people in groups and you always think people that are in the other group, you label them a certain way and stuff. And so I think that happens all the time and in a lot of different. One of the gals that I just had on last week or her show just went out yesterday, Tanis Cornell, we were talking about women and some of the things that women have to go through in the workforce and what her company does to actually equip them to navigate politically through the workforce,
you know?
So, and she was talking about how, you know, for instance, like men will get jobs based on their performance, like what they, you know, or not performance, excuse me, their potential, what they, the potential that they have going forward, whereas women have to prove what they've done in order to get that. So I think that happens a lot. And I can certainly, I guess, I remember going through anything like that, but I can certainly understand that being something that, having worked through. So who would you say has been your greatest influencers over the years?
There's been so many.
Sure.
Like all of us, right? Well, first and foremost would be my mom. She was a professor back in the 70s, 80s, and she had a PhD.
Okay.
And most of the time, she was the only female on staff for the university she worked at. And so I grew up on college campuses, and she would be in lecture halls, and I would be, you know, roller skating on the campus or whatever. So she was, she just taught me that, you know, you can become and be anything you want to be. And I love my mom for that. She's super sweet and healthy. And right now she's just doing awesome, takes care of herself. So she's been a really big influence. Probably the other one would be my husband. As I said, he retired military. And so we spent the last 20 years, you know, him serving formally and me serving informally and our children. So, I think his ability really to promote being a team is awesome. And he's not, you know, military people, and I love military people, don't get me wrong, but some can be somewhat bravado about their skills, their leadership, what they've done and all that kind of thing. But my husband is not one of those people. So he's really humble, down to earth. And he doesn't talk about how to be a team. Like, he's a team player. And he's a team player professionally, personally, with our kids, you know. And so that's been a profound influence. And I've learned a lot from him, you know, as he's grown up, per se. We've grown up together. But just really being a team has been – his influence on that has been just unsurmountable. I don't even think I could – you know, quantify that.
I love it. No, that's awesome. I always love asking this question because I just get so many different answers. And it is a hard question because we have so many influencers over the years. I mean, you have your parents and then you've got, you know, educators or people that have been in the early years of your lives. And then as you grow up, you've got more. So I always have a hard time with that one too. I have to like really think about it. That's why I send it to you ahead of time so you can look at it. Think about that question, right? So I want to jump, kind of switch gears a little bit and get to know Mica just a little. We've done this, talked a little bit about the Tokyoscape. So I'm going to ask you some fun questions. These are not hard, so don't worry.
Is it like 3-second rule?
Kind of stuff. It's easy, I promise. I don't ever tell anybody these because I like them to be, what's the word I'm looking for? I like them to just be what comes to mind.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Spontaneous.
Spontaneous.
Be like spontaneous. Okay. So what do you like to do for fun besides travel to Tokyo?
I love to travel. So something I've been doing a lot lately, which has been awesome, has been reading. Been back into reading. I've read this much since I was probably a preteen.
I love that.
Like, and then hiking, actually. You know, before we left Japan, we really got into hiking. There's actually a lot of mountains there. People wouldn't expect that, but there are. And so hiking and walking on the trails, and due to everything going on, I've been able to do a lot of that lately. So that's been pretty awesome. And then our family, we're a bunch of skiers. We love to ski.
Awesome.
So, yeah. I mean, we're in Texas, although my daughter, when we moved here, she goes, Mom, not a lot of people ski here. I'm like, well, it's Texas.
Yeah.
It's hot.
Yeah. Not a lot of snow here.
She's like, where will we go? I'm like, there's things around here, you know, Colorado and other New Mexico, places right. like that. So, and my off time, definitely reading, hiking, getting exercise, getting outside. We're a pretty active family. So, and we've tried to really instill that in our kids because I feel like as a parent, one of the best things you can give your kids is health.
I would agree with you.
Like how yeah. to get enough sleep, how to eat right, how to keep active, you know, mind, body, and spirit. Mm-hmm. So we're a pretty active family. So yeah.
I love that. So what good book, what are you reading right now? I love books. That's why I'm asking you this. What are you reading right now?
I'm actually reading two books. So I'm reading this book called Women Who Launched, and it's all about female entrepreneurs way back, like I want to say like 1800s, doing different businesses and how they, you know, how they launched huge cosmetic companies to, you know, cleaning supplies that have actually become a staple, you know, now. So, and then I'm also reading this other series that my daughter got me into, and it's a love series, and it's pretty
fun.
Neat.
Yeah, because something different,
yeah, right?
Yeah,
and she's like, there's a movie coming out, so you need to read this.
Oh, that's awesome. That's okay. So awesome. No, I love to read. That's why I was asking that. And I'm a big, you know, when I coach clients and stuff, that's one of the things I talk about all the time is, what are you reading? Mm-hmm. What are you putting into your headspace? Mm-hmm. Because if you're not
right.
putting stuff in there, then you're hearing all the other negative stuff, and that can overtake. And so, and I always talk about this too, even for me, like when I'm not reading, I'm not creative. Like everything just sort of kind of stops for me. Mm-hmm. It's like, because you get so wrapped up in all of the outside world stuff and nothing, you know, positive is coming. And so I love that you're doing that. And I love that you guys are active. I love that too.
We, yes. I think along with reading and just like anything else, you know, what you're saying about what you put in your mind, you know, you are what you listen to, mm-hmm. who you talk to, mm-hmm. who do you associate with? That's who you are. And I'm always telling my teens that, especially now, right. you know, something about Japan that they really miss now being in the States is, you know, we didn't have all the social media that we have here in Japan. I mean, we had some of it, but it just wasn't always in your face on billboards, on the TV, you know, that kind of thing. So I always warn them about, you know, what you're looking at,
right.
what you're playing on YouTube, all that kind of thing, because you are what you surround yourself with.
I would agree with you.
Yeah.
I would agree with you. All right. So morning or night person?
So I'm a night person. I would say I used to be a morning person when they were little, but now that they've grown up and, you know, my teenagers could sleep till, you know,
yeah.
And
now
it's like, you gotta,
are they
gotta
in
hurl.
There?
It's like, it's time to get up.
Yes.
It's 11 o'clock.
Right. Yes. I have to do that. I will do that. It's so funny because I think that happened. It was either yesterday or today. I can't remember. Yesterday or today. I just said that. I'm like, has anybody seen Paige yet? Has she come out of her room? It was like 2 p.m. because they do, they sleep all day. And you're like, are they in there? So I get it. I get it. All right. Cat or dog person?
Definitely dog.
Definitely dog. Do you guys have a dog?
We have a dog, and
okay,
guess
awesome.
What his name is.
What's his name?
It's a Japanese name.
Oh, I won't be able to guess that.
His name is Wasabi.
Oh, Wasabi. I love it. What kind of dog is it? I love it.
He's like a border collie, Australian shepherd. He's a mutt we rescued.
Yeah.
Because my kids were, oh, Mom, can we get a dog? Can we get
yeah.
a dog? We left Japan. Our previous dog passed. And they're like, we really want a dog. And I'm like, but if we get a dog, we have to ship the dog back from Japan. So we're going to wait
right.
until we get stateside.
Yeah. So that is awesome. I love that you rescued the dog too.
Yes.
I love it. So you just got brownie points with me. I love that because we do the same thing. We have a menagerie, but they're all rescues.
Mm.
Like, I don't know that I've ever, maybe we bought like a rabbit from the pet store, but like most of our animals have been like rescued. Even all the other rabbits, we've rescued them from like rabbit shelter type places and stuff.
Yes.
So I love that. Mm. That's awesome. All right. Summer or winter person?
I am definitely a summer person with the exception of skiing. I like to ski and go ski when there's snow,
right.
but if there's snow and hail and ice and
forget it.
No.
Yeah, forget
I'm
it. I'm with you on that. I'm a summer too. I always feel like in the summer, you can cool off, but it is hard to get warm when you're really cold. You know what I mean? Like when your insides are cold, it is just hard to get warm.
Yes.
You know? I go through that sometimes when I drink cold liquids, like my insides just get that cold feeling. And I'm like, okay, I need to go take a hot shower.
Oh,
so
yeah.
So it's just hard to warm up. So I'm with you. And there's so much you can do in the summer, you know?
Oh, yeah.
There's so much fun stuff you can do. So this is kind of a to get you to think question. And I'm going to ask you one more. We'll wrap it up here. But how do you define success?
You didn't send me that one.
No, but I figured you could probably get this
okay.
one.
How do I define success?
What do you think of
success?
When you think of success?
I think if you are doing what you're passionate about and what you're good at, then you're going to be successful.
See, I love that. I knew you would get it. I love that answer. That's probably something I would say.
Yeah.
I love it. No, I didn't ask you that question. I kind of snuck that one in there. I wanted to see what you'd say. But no, I think that's good. I like that. All right. And if this one I did send you. So if you could pick any character for the day, what would you pick?
I did think about this one. So we're a huge, you know, movie fans. We have kids. So, of course, you watch a lot of movies, right? I really like Elastigirl. From The Incredibles. She's the mom.
Yeah.
She kind of holds it all together. I really identify with her.
I could see that.
Yes.
I love that. That's a good one. I've never had anybody say that one. That was a unique one.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I love doing this. I love it. I like to see what people say because, you know, we'll get kind of the cliche ones that kind of come around and they'll repeat them a little bit. But then that one we have not had.
Elastigirl is pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I always say the same too. Tinkerbell and what's the other one? I'm drawing her name now or forgetting her name. She's on the Marvels.
There's a lot.
I know she's like the one that's in the flies in the air and say I'm drawing a blank, but we'll just go Captain Marvel. Yeah, no, is that the girl? I thought that was the guy.
No, that's
is it the girl?
Yeah.
Okay, that's her. That's her. I'm losing. I'm like, who's my character? She's my character, but I like Tinkerbell. She's my favorite character.
I can see that.
Tinkerbell's my favorite. All right. So if our listeners, I'm going to get serious. No more fun. All right. If our listeners wanted to learn a little bit more about Tokyo Escapes and a little bit about you, how do they plug in to find you?
So this is easy. We have a website, tokyoescapes.com. And then we're also on Facebook and Instagram. And my email's on there, number, everything. So it's pretty easy to get in contact with us.
So right now, there's no traveling.
Correct.
So the next big thing we're looking for is hopefully to go to the Olympics. Is that like the next thing y'all are
Well, thinking? I do have some trips planned for later this year. We're just going to see if they take off.
Yeah.
And I do also have some trips planned for the spring. Cherry blossoms are famous in Japan. People come from all over the world to see the cherry blossoms. So I do have some of those trips planned. And then, of course, the Olympics. And as I said, I still have Olympic tickets. And just so everyone knows, they're really hard to get.
So awesome. I love it. All right. And we'll be sure when this goes out, I'll make sure that we get your contact information in the show so that if anybody wants to go to the website, check it out, learn a little bit more. We'll get it out there for you. So, all right. So with that, I want to say to our listeners, first of all, thank you, Mica, for being on the show. I'm so glad we got to connect today. And you're a lot of fun. I just said you're always fun to chat with. I enjoy the conversation. And so to our listeners, if you enjoy our podcast, please be sure that you give us a rating on both iTunes and Facebook because we cannot do this without you. And hit that subscribe button on the YouTube so you can keep up. I do put other videos on there that I don't do at the podcast studio. So if you're not on there, you're missing those. And with that, I'm going to wrap up with our mantra. It's a great day to be brave. You might as well start now. You have the power to change your circumstances any day you decide. Let today be that day. Rise up, be amazing, be you, do you. All right, you guys take care, be safe, and be kind to one another. We'll see you next time.